Hi, I am Hannah Lee. I've been here since, let's say, 2016.
Okay.
2016, and actually, I'm not a teacher. Originally, I'm not a teacher. I'm a seller. Mm-hmm. I'm a chef and I'm a seller.
Oh, okay. That's good for you.
I started teaching 2018. So I knew. Mm-hmm. But I wasn't aware that teaching was my calling.
Mm-hmm.
It started by accident. So maybe later on, I may share to you, but by the way, I have two kids. Mm-hmm. I have two kids, one son, and he's around 13 years old, and one baby girl, 4 years old, international age, mm-hmm. and I think she's around 6 years old here in Korea.
Mm, okay.
I teach at Tuntun English Master Academy.
Oh.
Three. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday.
Ah,
I also teach by Skype.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And I am 31 years old, young. Nice to meet you, Mom Daphne and Mom Pinalanga.
Yeah, nice to meet you too.
Happy privilege to be here.
Right. And thank you so much for granting my request, dear.
No, it's a pleasure.
Yes, okay, thank you. It's our chance actually, right, to know each other more. Okay, and share our teaching experience here in Korea. Well, actually, I am very grateful, my darling, kasi talagang binigyan niyo ako ng oras. Right.
Talaga, talaga.
Very nice school. Okay. So how about you, teacher Daphne? How about you? Same question?
Yeah, so oh my gosh, okay. So actually, so I've been here in Korea since 2007.
Mm.
So that was actually almost 14 years ago.
Mm.
So actually, as everyone knows, we are married to Korean.
Yes, that's
so actually I finished my degree in Philippines as a high school math teacher.
Oh.
But when I was in Philippines, I never had any experience about teaching because right after graduation, I worked in a logistics company as a customer service representative for almost 2 years.
Mm.
Yeah, during the time, so when I was working in a company somewhere in Makati, so I met my husband. So we got married.
Of course.
So actually, it was not really. That was another side of the story. So not that I was sure. So I met my husband. I got married. So as a result, I had to go to Korea, right? So that was 2007, and it's kind of really funny because I never imagined that I would be a teacher here in Korea.
Mm.
Yeah, because I never had any experience teaching. Although I had my, you know, my practical when we were in our last year in college, but. When I get to Korea, it's kind of funny because right after I arrived in Korea on September 12th, that was Wednesday, so the next week, Monday, I already started working in a Hagwon, a private institute. Can you imagine that?
Whoa,
that was kind of really, really, really big challenge because, you know, you were such in a really strange environment, you were adapting, and then, you know, you don't know exactly what will be the life in Korea, but it was a really tough challenge, but yeah, but that's great. So I was able to overcome all those kinds of stress and difficulties, and since then, I started working in Hagwon, and then I moved to another bigger Hagwon, and in a couple of years, I already started working in a community center with other students, and maybe I also got some private degree also. Until now, but since there's a pandemic, so it was temporarily closed. So yeah, I'm just doing online class most of the time. So I'm so pleased and I'm so really happy to meet these lovely teachers, Mom, teacher Hannah and Mom Pinalanga. So I think this will be a really, really great content. So yeah, I'm looking forward for it. Thank you.
Yes. Oh, well said. Bravo. Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
So I have asked also another question still about your teaching experience. Okay, so and you mentioned earlier that you arrived here 2017, right?
2007.
I'm so sorry. Okay, 2007. That's right. Okay, so how was your first teaching experience?
Of course, I mean, you also experienced the same thing I experienced, right? So when I arrived on my first class, because the first class started at around 3:15 in the afternoon, because they have to attend their school, and after they have to go to private academies or happens. So my first class was really young kids. Can you imagine that? They were first graders or maybe second graders.
Mm.
And it was kind of really, how can I say, it was really tough. It was really, really stressful because, you know, they couldn't express themselves in English, right?
You are
in Korean and you don't have any idea about Korean languages. So I know you two already also experienced the same thing, right?
Yes, really
so that's kind of really tough. But with the help of my director, the owner of the academy, because the director of the academy, she had experienced studying in the Philippines for about 2 years because she studied in the University of the Philippines. She's Korean and then she got married to an American guy, so they only have one.
Okay.
And so it was really easy for me to deal with the teaching because they were really there to assist me and to help me, especially when it comes to teaching because, you know, as I told you, I never had any experience about teaching and taking other Koreans. So it was really tough, So it was really difficult, but they went well, so I think it's just a common thing.
That's right. Okay, how about you, teacher Hannah?
My first experience was by accident.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I came here at that time. I had my 8-month-old baby girl.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I told you I have this friend of mine who lived in Korea for 21 years already this year, and he asked me, "Hey, Hannah, you know how to speak English, right?"
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I do. I'm gonna go to the Philippines for 1 week. Can you go to my class? Like how we call our big sisters in the Philippines. I have no idea how to teach kids. Yes, I want children because my dream is to have 5 children of my own.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know I'm really fond of kids.
Mm-hmm.
So. No, I'm gonna teach you everything, all the materials, I'm gonna teach you. I really have to go to Philippines, so please come around my class. And then my face was no, because I have no experience. And then she told me how much you're gonna pay me. So let's be realistic,
Exactly.
At that time, I am a full-time mom, and I just got birth. So I don't know where to work in Korea.
Mm-hmm.
I want to help my husband financially. Mm-hmm. And that time, I was living with my mother-in-law.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not sure what I can do.
Correct.
I want to be helpful.
Yeah,
so
right.
I said, oh, okay. Show me how to do it.
Yeah.
And then when I was there, it was like love at first sight.
Wow. Okay.
My heart was trembling. I was so happy.
Mm-hmm.
And then since personally, I'm a really jolly person. I am playful.
Mm-hmm.
And I can be a kid at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, this is my calling. So after this Philippine teacher came back, I asked her,
mm-hmm.
Abe, how to be you?
Mm-hmm.
How can I teach? I want this.
Mm-hmm.
And you know my style. If I want something, I'm going to pursue.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not easy because you have a 4-year degree. Because you're in Korea, if you really want this, you have to have, so you need your 4-year degree and some certificates. So I said, yes, I do. Okay, and it's because that time, the same year, I was planning to go back to Philippines to finish some of my errands left there. So he said, since you're going back to Philippines and your degree is kind of far from teaching disciplinary arts, why don't you try to get TESOL? So she's actually she's my mentor. So it started with an accident, and it was a love at first sight, and it became my calling. I know that this is what I want to do.
Until you are teaching.
That's awesome.
Wow, deep transformation. Okay, amazing story, inspiring story. So actually, ma'am, okay, to be a teacher is not really. I mean, it's so tough, right? Because you have different kinds of students, different individuals, different personalities, right? Yeah, it's not that easy. It's not about the. It's not about the money. It's about like how are you going to handle? Yeah.
Yes, and even you like seriously, even you like the income, even you like the money, if your heart is not into it.
Indeed, right? You have to love your job.
Yes.
That's why people actually like teaching, right?
Yes. Actually, I'm no offense, but I have like foreign teachers. Actually, I've been a friend with them, and even these foreign teachers, they say they give up. I've known one of the teachers give up and teach Koreans.
Okay. Well, I know some of the people also. Like, it's not about how you. I mean, it's not about that you can speak English alone.
But
yes. Dealing again, that's what I said earlier. Like dealing with people. Yeah. So,
yes.
Well, everyone has different teaching abilities, right? Even I think Mr. Duffin, you have your own approach, right? So with different level of students. So anyway, speaking of various kinds of students, have you ever experienced different level, like elementary, middle school, secondary students, and adult students, or even university students? You guys have experienced?
Everyone.
Okay, you guys have experience dealing with these people, dealing with these various kinds of students, advanced level, beginner, starter, or like, so to like average students, would you like to share? So your experience, based from your experience.
During the first 4 years or 5 years, maybe I worked as a full-time in Hagwon. I was just merely teaching elementary kids until middle school. So during those times, so since I was working as a full-time, so I was just focused on these young and middle school students. So, but I met some Koreans suggested how about to have a private tutorial, like one-to-one. As I can remember, so I had my first tutorial with a university student. Although her skill was really, how can I say, it's not really a beginner, but he has a little bit narrow knowledge of vocabularies. So it was a little difficult for us to deal with the class, but I think we just had about 3 months because she has to fly to the US. That was the first experience I had with my tutorial, and then after I worked as a full-time in Hagwon, that was really stressful, so I decided to get a class just part-time. So luckily I was able to get three times a week class, so I still have 2 days. So one of my fellow Filipino working in Korea suggested, how about teaching adults this, and wow, that was a really brilliant idea. So that started 2010, maybe. I started 2010, and it was kind of a little bit more interesting, and because it's totally different, the learners, and then the topic, and so far it went well. And the funny thing is that the class pursued until this year, so almost more than 10 years already. The class. So I work with them. Of course, some of the students are not already there. So every semester, because the class is almost 3 months, every 3 months. But it was kind of really surprising because every 3 months, I met a lot of adults. And that was really a big change on my life because my Korean skill improved a lot.
Because
these adults, because during the class, so they are speaking most of the time Korean because they are in person. So I already heard a lot of impressions. So I did all that. And then it was such a really great experience because it was not merely on teaching, but it was a kind of teaching and learning experience. So that was really one of the most rewarding part being a teacher in my life. So I owe them a lot. Of course, I also experienced working with the university students, but mostly I teach adult students, and that was really the best part of my teaching career since then. So yeah, it was really awesome. I'm going to give them a chance to work to teach. I would prefer to teach adult students because they are so generous.
Exactly.
It's so easy to deal, and it's not really stressful. So that's it. So I would really prefer working or teaching with adult students.
Okay, excellent. All right, I was so touched. Yes, well, thank you for saying that. Okay, how about you, teacher Hannah?
Yes, wow. Actually, I want to compliment teacher Daphne.
Oh, yeah.
So, yes, because for me, maybe the saying is right. We have different kinds of genre. Teaching, yes. But because for me, I have experience teaching university students and even a doctor. He is my daughter's doctor. Yes. It's very challenging. Yes, it's manageable for me. It's manageable, but it was not my genre. It was not my genre. It's so quiet. It's so quiet. And yes, because I'm not this kind of person, like so manageable. You need to speak like really good and really manageable. But I think my heart and my genre. But yes, I consider it for me. It was a big learning also for me. It taught me to be flexible. So anyway, but he went to Pyeongtaek already. So yes, it was a kind of exit for me. Earlier, I mentioned that I went to Philippines to study TESOL, and then when I came back here, an opportunity came right away. But I work for an agency who deploy teachers to Gurinichi.
Okay.
I think Gurinichi is like it's not kindergarten.
It's like nursery,
right? Nursery. And it was so fun. I don't know why I enjoyed the little children. I got there for 8 months because supposedly I told my deputy, the boss of the agency, I want a part-time job. Like I can teach and I can earn, but I cannot go full-time because my baby is around 1 year old. So I said, if you can give me an opportunity to give to teach like 2 days in a week, so at first it was good, but I also think that, but at the same time, it wasn't for me because she gave me like 6 days in a week with Saturday. But it was out of the commitment. We didn't joke about it. So I was like, ooh! And even the Koreans were, because it's an agency, so we have Korean, native, and Philippine teachers. So they were shocked. How come teacher Hannah got 6 times? I said, please get my class, I cannot. So anyway, to make the story short, I left the agency and then it broke my heart because I really wanted to see the children, because my priority is my little baby at the time. Okay, and then after that, the opportunity of teaching and I have one came. So I enjoyed it too. Until now, I am teaching from grade 1 to 中学生.
That's middle school, right? That's middle school?
Yes, yes. So it was so good. And like teacher Daphne, I also have an issue about children. Most of the time, as teacher Daphne said, they talk in Korean language. And then you tell them, guys, this is English time! But I don't know if Mom Palanga and Mom Daphne would agree with me. Okay. But in my case, I think, which is some of the bosses, some of the director that I met and my two bosses that I have right now, they also agree to this, that it is also essential that foreign teacher have also Korean language knowledge.
Yeah,
exactly.
For me, because some of the, let's face it, some of the academic directors, they have a rule, do not speak Korean.
Yeah, of course.
Do not let them, notice that you can understand Korean.
Yeah, absolutely.
But I find it useful. Mm-hmm. I find it useful that the children, the students, is aware that you can understand even basic Korean, mm-hmm. because they are comfortable to speak. Yeah, that's only for my point of view. I don't know. But hopefully it was fun. Teaching in Korea to Korean students, and they are smart. Okay. They're smart. Yeah. They are very smart and they always want to win. Mm. They always want to win. I'm the best. Yeah. So I think anywhere you go, any country you go, people, their personalities are all different.
Yeah.
So just have to respect and, you know, go with the flow, whatever. But basically it's fun. Teaching is fun.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good enough, right? And another question. Okay, do you have any experience working with like retired people?
Retired?
Yes, yeah, working
like on teaching,
like, oh, yes, oh, yeah. Like seniors, or I just want to know, I'm just curious.
Because for me,
I don't have.
How about in my case, I have. So, I started working in a senior welfare center in 2018, wow. I guess 2018 or 19. So, one of my fellow teachers before recommended how about having a, because she is working in that senior welfare center, teaching basic English. And then the community center also suggested how about having foreign class with a foreign teacher. So yeah, so she recommended me, so it was a nice offer, so it was a good pay. That was a really good one. So I took the opportunity, so I worked with them, so at the beginning it was really nice, because they were all senior, okay, so most of the students are from 62 to 80. And they are so lovely, you know, because, so it might be because I can communicate in Korean, so maybe that is a really good, so a teacher Hannah mentioned a while ago that having a little knowledge about Korean language is really a big advantage, actually. So I agree with this one. So but since they are there not to learn, just to have fun, because they are seniors, so they just want to spend the time. So it's not really, they don't have to study just to get a 100 score or maybe to use, just, you just want to spend the time just to, how can I say, to kill the time, just to kill the time, because they're already seniors, right?
Yes.
So when I was working with them, it was really good, because the textbook was really easy, the basic one, but for them, you know, so maybe the mental ability is not as the way before, because as you get older, maybe your memory skill, everything is a little bit different. So every time I have class with them, it was a really good experience, because they really want me to just share.